I think there was some glitch that last video ended abruptly. I'll wait for 1 minute more so that more people can join. I don't know how the last session got ended abruptly. All right, so I'll begin. First of all, thank you, Amit and Priya and Team Desi Kanun, for calling me over again to discuss about this topic, the criminal liability of the promoters, directors, and key managerial personnel. I personally believe that India is going to see a lot of litigation in this particular segment in the coming time because this is an evolving subject. Various judgments have evolved this law, and there are a lot of scope wherein a lawyer can show certain kind of creativity and put in their point. So I'll begin with it. And congratulations, T. Kanun. I've heard that you have crossed over 30,000 followers. It's a great feat. Within such a short span of time, you have achieved this. You have come into this platform. So all the best. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the criminal liability of directors, promoter, and key managerial personnel. So first of all, we have to understand that a company and the persons who are running the company are two different legal entities. A company, as everyone knows, as our statute defines it, and also defines the individual persons, there is a lot of difference in it. I feel that there are two eras in India where this law is differentiated. That is a pre-2005 era and post-2005 era. We are basically dealing with three segments of law. A law of 1872, that is IPC, which defines the criminality. A law which is a procedural law, 1973 CRPC, and a now new law of Companies Act, which is recently amended in 2013. So a synchronization is a biggest challenge for the legislation, for the judiciary, even for the lawyers and for a layman, for a directors, key managerial personnel to understand that what are their liabilities and how they can be immune from any criminal liability arising out of their actions. So I'll tell you, before 2005, a body corporate was not imputed for the criminal liability and criminal actions, because as a layman would say that how can a company be imprisoned? How can an organization can be sent to a jail? So pre-2005, this was a general perception, and courts were guided by this, and hence all the liabilities which arose on the companies were civil liabilities, and maximum fines were imposed, but there was no criminal liability imposed on them. So a constitution bench judgment came in 2005 by the name of I will say that whatever sections I will quote and whatever judgments I will quote, because it is a judgment-driven law. Whatever judgments I will quote, please write it down, everyone, so that later on when you will read it, you can easily relate, और आपको ये टॉपिक इतना इजीली समझ में आ जाएगा दैट इट्स अ क्रोनोलॉजी दैट हाउ इट गॉट इन्वॉल्व एंड वट सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेड नाउ इट इज लॉ ऑफ द लैंड. सो कमिंग बैक, in 2005, Supreme Court in a constitution bench judgment in Standard Chartered Bank versus Directorate of Enforcement 2005 constitution bench, there were two points in front of Supreme Court. The issues for consideration were that whether a company or a corporate body could be prosecuted for which a sentence of imprisonment is a mandatory punishment, whether a body corporate can be prosecuted for imprisonment, and the second point is that where an accused is found guilty एंड द पनिशमेंट टू बी इम्पोज इज अ इम्प्रिजनमेंट एंड फाइन वेदर द कोर्ट हैज गॉट द डिस्क्रिशन टू इम्पोज द फाइन अलोन. सो इफ अ स्टैट्यूट सेज दैट अंडर फेरा एक्ट out of a civil appeal from a Bombay High Court where Standard Chartered Bank was prosecuted, and then they came in the appeal that we cannot be prosecuted as per the present statute. So the appellant's contention were that when a statute prescribes punishment for imprisonment and fine, it is not permissible for court to award punishment of fine alone. A corporation being a juristic person cannot be awarded imprisonment and there is no sense in prosecuting somebody when the punishment cannot be awarded as per the mandate of the statute. So they wanted to go scot-free. They did not want even that prosecution can be launched against them because there is a large contradiction on the definition of offense and the punishment of the offense. So Supreme Court decided, they went into the root of the matter and then they found out that the section 11 of the IPC defines person. So who is the person as per section 11 of the IPC? The word person includes any company or association of body of persons, whether incorporated or no. So यहाँ से उन्होंने ये रूट ढूंढी कि कंपनी तो पर्सन के अंदर भी आती है, तो why a company cannot be prosecuted? So this was the main sense. They derived this meaning that legislator wants to say that a person does not mean an individual. A person may mean a body corporate or a company or a corporation also. So finally, they concluded in this manner that with the globalization, India was experiencing a lot of corporatization was happening and new companies were coming up. So it is very necessary that a company, in the name of lack of legislative intent and lack of legal prudence, I will say, can go scot-free. And they wanted that it should not happen that due to the absence of the possibility of criminal liability, a corporations would escape the moral conviction for their wrongdoings. It was given in the judgment that corporate will continue to go scot-free in such cases and shall always have the defense of being a juristic person. So person ko unhone define kar diya ki body corporate and corporations will come. So finally they concluded that the current position is that the corporations can no longer claim immunity from criminal prosecutions on the ground that they are incapable of possessing the necessary mens rea, jo mens rea hum IPC mein padhte hain, for the commission of criminal offenses. The notion that a corporation cannot be held liable for commission of a crime has been rejected. So Standard Chartered Bank judgment ne ye bahut clear kar diya ki ab jo body corporates hain, organizations hain, unke liye criminal liability arise ho sakti hai. 2005 tak ye notion nahi tha. Yahan pe ek humko level playing field mil gayi. Now companies can be prosecuted. Then another question came, when the company can be prosecuted, then who in the company is to be prosecuted? Whether it is a director or a manager or a secretary or a managing director or a joint MD, who is to be prosecuted? So within 2005, again a new judgment came from Supreme Court in October. And a landmark judgment, I would say, that talks about the strict and vicarious liability. I will come on that also. On the later part of this session. So a three judge bench SMS pharmaceutical judgment, it talked about that who will be the person who will be prosecuted when the company will be prosecuted. Abhi tak, I'm sorry. अभी तक स्टैंडर्ड चार्टर्ड केस के अंदर ये क्लियर हुआ कि कंपनी इज अ बॉडी कॉर्पोरेट, इट इज अ पर्सन, सो दे कैन बी प्रोसिक्यूटेड. बट नाउ द क्वेश्चन केम इन फ्रंट ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट दैट हु इन द कंपनी. सो जनरली व्हाट हैपेंड दैट लॉट ऑफ लिटिगेशन केम इन द नेम ऑफ डायरेक्टर. फलाना पर्सन साइन कर रहा है और डायरेक्टर को आप समन कर रहे हैं, आप मैनेजर को समन कर रही है मजिस्ट्रेट कोर्ट्स. दे वांटेड टू ब्रिंग अ क्लियर गाइडलाइन कि इसके अंदर हु कैन बी समन्ड एंड हु कैन नॉट बी समन्ड. सो एसएमएस फार्मास्यूटिकल केस वाज बेसिकली अबाउट दैट द पर्संस हु आर इन चार्ज ऑफ द कंपनी एंड दोज हु आर डायरेक्टली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द कमीशन ऑफ एन ऑफेंस शैल बी हेल्ड लायबल एंड नॉट एवरी अदर पर्सन. So a company may have 1,000 employees, may have 50 directors. So all 50 directors cannot be prosecuted. But I tell you, there is a problem with on the legislative side. So if you have read Negotiable Instrument Act, before beginning this judgment, I'll tell you the basic about that. If you will read about Negotiable Instrument Act, Section 138. Section 138 kya kehta hai? Section 138 talks about the prosecution of and the punishment for the offenses under Negotiable Instrument Act for the punishment for the check bouncing. And what does 141 says? That who all can be imputed. Now I'll tell you that 141, I think when it was made, there was not a clear intent of executive and legislature that how a person is to be imputed for their legal liability in the company. So 141 says it's a vicarious liability. अगर कंपनी ने ऑफेंस किया है, कंपनी के अंदर जितने भी लोग हैं, ठीक है, उस उन सब लोगों को उसके अंदर लायबल किया जाएगा. 141 says, which I personally do not somehow in consonance with this, it says every person, 141 says every person who at the time of offense was committed, was in charge of and was responsible company for the conduct of the business of the company as well as the company shall be deemed to be guilty. So it started with every person shall be deemed to be guilty of the offense and shall be liable to be proceeded against and punished accordingly. So yahan pe ambiguity aa gayi. Supreme Court in this case they cleared this ambiguity. So Supreme Court ke aage teen basic points aaye is judgment mein, SMS pharmaceutical judgments of 2005, that who are the persons who can be charged or responsible for the conduct of the business of the company. Second point, whether a director of a company would be deemed to be in charge of and responsible of the company for the conduct of business of company and therefore deemed to be guilty of offense unless he proved it to the contrary. Wo stage bahut baad mein aati hai, tab tak aadmi harass ho chuka hota hai, summoning ho chuki hoti hai, bail leta hai, sab cheeze hoti hai, process issue ho chuka hota hai. तो अनलेस ही प्रूव्ड कॉन्ट्ररी, तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट के पास ये मैटर आया कि क्या डायरेक्टर हर केस में इंप्यूट किया जा सकता है. और थर्ड आया, इसको आप बहुत ध्यान से सुनना क्योंकि लास्ट जो जजमेंट का निचोड़ आएगा वो जजमेंट इसको बेसिकली जो जजमेंट का इसके अंदर निचोड़ आएगा वो जजमेंट इस पॉइंट के ऊपर बहुत क्रिटिकल है. नाउ व्हाट द थर्ड पॉइंट इन फ्रंट ऑफ सुप्रीम कोर्ट वॉज, इवन इफ इट इज हेल्ड दैट स्पेसिफिक एवेयरमेंट्स आर नेसेसरी, whether in the absence of such averments the signatory of the check and or the MD or the joint MD who admittedly would be in charge of the company and responsible to the company for the conduct of its business could be proceeded against. So director ho sakta hai ki nahi, aur ye point ki joint MD, signatory or MD could be proceeded against or not, सुप्रीम कोर्ट के आगे ये बात आई. और 141 को उन्होंने वाइकेरियस लायबिलिटी को डिस्कस इसके अंदर किया कि एवरी पर्सन का क्या मतलब है, व्हाट डज एवरी पर्सन से. इफ अ कंपनी हैज 1000 एम्प्लॉइज, इट डज इट मीन दैट ऑल 1000 एम्प्लॉइज कैन बी समन्ड ऑन वन चेक बाउंसिंग. सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट आंसर्स, नाउ आई टेल यू हाउ. सो इट बेसिकली सेड दैट 138 कास्ट क्रिमिनल लायबिलिटी पनिशेबल विद इंप्रिजनमेंट और फाइन और विद बोथ ऑन अ पर्सन हु इश्यूज अ चेक towards discharge of a debt or liability as a whole or in part and the check is dishonored by the bank on presentation. Now 138 to ye ho gaya, ab aapka offense banega. Ab 141 extends such criminal liability in case place or company to every person who at time of offense was in charge. अब ये 141 की बात कर रहा है, टू एवरी पर्सन हु एट द टाइम ऑफ ऑफेंस वॉज इन चार्ज ऑफ एंड वॉज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द कंडक्ट ऑफ बिजनेस ऑफ द कंपनी. सो नाउ कमिंग देन सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेड दैट 138 व्हेन अ कंप्लेंट कम्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ मैजिस्ट्रेट, मैजिस्ट्रेट विल हैव टू ऑप्शंस, ऑप्शन ऑफ 203 सीआरपीसी और 204 सीआरपीसी. 203 के अंदर मैजिस्ट्रेट को क्या लगता है, वो कंप्लेंट को अपना जुडिशियस माइंड अप्लाई करता है, देन ही विल डिसाइड वेदर द प्रोसेस इज टू बी इशूड और ही कैन रिजेक्ट. सो 203 एम्पावर्स अ मैजिस्ट्रेट टू डिसमिस अ कंप्लेंट विदाउट इवन इशूइंग अ प्रोसेस. उसके पास कंप्लेंट आई, उसको लगा कि इसके अंदर ये बोगस कंप्लेंट है, इसके अंदर लायबिलिटी इंप्यूट नहीं हो रही, वो वहां पे 203 सीआरपीसी के अंदर उसको डिसमिस कर सकता है. दो वर्ड्स इसमें इंपॉर्टेंट है फॉर अ मैजिस्ट्रेट ऑल्सो इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर जुडिशरी, इस बात को आप ध्यान रखना. It uses the word after considering and the magistrate is of the opinion that there is no sufficient ground for proceeding. 203 में वो वहाँ पे उसको complaint को उड़ा सकता है. Then, so what does it means that the magistrate has to apply his mind to a complaint at the initial stage itself and see whether a case is made out against the accused person before issuing process to them on the basis of complaint. So, 203 नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट एक्ट में इंपॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि अगर वो किसी डायरेक्टर को प्रोसेस इशू कर देता है ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कंप्लेंट, सो उसके अगेंस्ट समनिंग हो जाएगी. नाउ आई टेल यू कि इसमें लीग एक टेक्निकल चीज क्या है, और जो क्रिमिनल साइड पे केसेस होते हैं उसके अंदर एक्यूज हैज एम्पल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिफेंड हिमसेल्फ टू प्रूव हिज बोनाफाइड दैट ही इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बाय द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ. बट इन 138 केसेस there is a legal problem that once a notice is issued, then there is no remedy to the accused person to whom the summon is issued to go and persuade that court. He will have to go in 397 into the session court in revision or maybe with the concurrent jurisdiction to the high court. So, ये एक बहुत बड़ा लकुना है. इसके लिए दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट में आज भी एक रेफरेंस पेंडिंग है. आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग जब कोर्ट्स ओपन होगी तो इस पे रेफरेंस जरूर आएगा. आप उसको बिल्कुल देसी भाषा में समझ लीजिए कि आज अगर 138 की कोर्ट मैजिस्ट्रेट की किसी को समन इशू करती है तो वो एक्यूज को बिना सुने समन इशू करती है, और एक्यूज के पास दूसरे केसेस जैसे जो क्रिमिनल केसेस है उसमें चार्ज फ्रेमिंग पे जो मौका होता है चार्ज पे बहस करने का, वो 138 में नहीं होता. तो उसके अगेंस्ट अगर नोटिस फ्रेम होके समन इशू हो गए तो ही विल ओनली हैव ऑप्शन ऑफ रिवीजन इन सेशंस और हाई कोर्ट. सो इन 138 मैजिस्ट्रेट्स हैव टू अप्लाई अ लॉट ऑफ जुडिशियस माइंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ कंप्लेंट. इफ दे आर इशूइंग प्रोसेस अंडर 204 दे हैव टू बी सेटिस्फाइड दैट अ प्रोसेस कैन बी इशूड एंड कंप्लेंट के अंदर दम है कि उसकी जो कंप्लेंट है वो जेन्युइन है और उसने जो डॉक्यूमेंट्स एनेक्स किए हैं दैट प्रूव्स दैट समहाउ द पर्सन हुम द कोर्ट इज समनिंग इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट प्राइमा फेसी. तो ये आप समझ गए 138 के अंदर अगर समन इशू आपके क्लाइंट को होते हैं, अगर आपके क्लाइंट्स डायरेक्टर्स प्रमोटर्स हैं तो आप उनको ये एडवाइस करिए that they immediately have to go to the session court or to the high court for revision against the summoning order, because that particular magistrate court will not have that power. So magistrate has to be very equally judicious in issuing the process under 204. So SMS pharmaceutical ke andar humne basically bhi ye dekha ki kin logo ko हम इंप्यूट कर सकते हैं. तो हमने देखा 138 क्या कहता है, 141 क्या कहता है, और 203 204 के अंदर मैजिस्ट्रेट की क्या पावर है. अब सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने इस चीज को डिफाइन कर दिया. नाउ सुप्रीम कोर्ट कम्स टू अ पॉइंट, नाउ इट सेज एंड इट मेक्स इट क्लियर देयर इज नो यूनिवर्सल रूल दैट अ डायरेक्टर ऑफ अ कंपनी इज इन चार्ज ऑफ इट्स एवरीडे अफेयर्स. दिस इज द क्रक्स ऑफ दिस जजमेंट. देयर इज नो यूनिवर्सल रूल दैट अ डायरेक्टर और इन चार्ज ऑफ अ Director of the company is in charge of its everyday affairs. We have discussed about the position of a director in a company in order to illustrate the point that there is no magic as such in a particular word, be it director, manager or secretary. As one says that there is nothing in the name, this judgment says there is nothing in the designation. It can be a director, it can be a manager or it can be a secretary. It doesn't matter. Supreme Court says that it doesn't matter. There is no universal rule. There is no magic as such in a particular world. It all depends upon the respective roles assigned to the officers in a company. A company may have managers or secretaries for different departments, which means it may have more than one manager or secretary. These officers may also be authorized to issue checks under their signatures with respect to the affairs of the respective department. Supreme Court ne clear kar diya. Standard Chartered Bank judgment mein kehta hai, body corporate organization companies ko, they can be prosecuted. उसके चार महीने बाद SMS फार्मास्यूटिकल केस में कहता है कि हमको ये देखना है कि क्रिमिनली लायबल अगर हमको किसी को करना है तो डायरेक्टली हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. देर इज नो यूनिवर्सल रूल कि आप डायरेक्टर को सम्मान कर दोगे, मैनेजर को कर दोगे, सेक्रेटरी को कर दोगे. देर इज नो यूनिवर्सल रूल. यू हैव टू सी दैट हु वॉज द ऑथराइज सिग्नेटरी, हु वॉज द इंचार्ज एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर 138 कोर्ट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस. तो ये यहां पे क्लियर हो गया. उसके बाद सुप्रीम कोर्ट फिर रिएट्रेट करती है दैट नॉट एवरी पर्सन कनेक्टेड विद अ कंपनी इज मेड लायबल अंडर 141. क्या कहता था? एवरी पर्सन. जो लेजिस्लेटिव इंटेंट थी वो भी ठीक थी, वो अभी आ गया पता लगेगा. सुप्रीम कोर्ट उसको डिफाइन करता है, उसको इंटरप्रेट करता है एवरी पर्सन का क्या मतलब है. बट सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेज नॉट एवरी पर्सन कनेक्टेड विद द कंपनी इज मेड लायबल अंडर 141. लायबिलिटी इज कास्ट ऑन पर्संस हु मे हैव समथिंग टू डू विद द ट्रांजैक्शन. A person who is in charge of and responsible for conduct of business of a company would naturally know why the check-in question was issued and why it got dishonored. जो आदमी in charge है उसी को ही पता है ना कि check issue क्यों हुआ है और क्यों dishonored हुआ है. Somebody in Chennai signs a check, issues it, it gets dishonored. Will a manager sitting in Delhi know it? No, it will not be known to him. So if you get any of the case in future course where you see that your client is unnecessary is been summoned and you have to save him from clutches of law, SMS pharmaceutical case will help you. There is one more Anita Hada judgment. I'll come later to that also. So now Supreme Court says what is required is that persons who are sought to be made criminally liable under section 144 should be at the time the offence was committed in charge of and responsible to the company for the conduct of business of the company. Every person connected with the company shall not fall within the ambit of this provision. It is only those persons connected with the company. It is only those persons who were in charge of and responsible for conduct of business of the company at the time of commission of an offence who will be liable for criminal action. It follows from this that if a director of a company who was not in charge and who was not responsible for the conduct of business of the company at the relevant time will not be liable under this provision, under 141. तो ये बात आपको समझ में आ गई? It says liability depends on the role one plays in the affairs of a company and not on the designation on status. So Supreme Court ne crystal clear kar diya ki ye kaise hoga. So there is a question by Chirag. Chirag, at the end I'll take questions. Please send this query at that time. So now a very very important point which I want to say. So third point which I said that the authorized signatory, managing director and joint MD. इसमें लॉ क्या प्रिज्यूम करता है, इसमें सुप्रीम कोर्ट क्या प्रिज्यूम कर रहा है. सो इस जजमेंट के थ्रू उसको भी क्लियर उन्होंने कर दिया दैट डायरेक्टर, मैनेजर, सेक्रेटरी को तो हम बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ डेजिग्नेशन, ऐसा नहीं है, हम उनको समनिंग करवा देंगे. कंप्लेंट उसके अगेंस्ट जो दी जाएगी उसमें समनिंग हो जाएगी. बट सुप्रीम कोर्ट मेड वन प्रोविजन विच सेज दैट मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर, जॉइंट मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर एंड द ऑथराइज सिग्नेटरी would be admittedly in charge of the company and responsible to the company for conduct of its business. When that is so, holders of such position in a company become liable under section 141 of the act. तो आपके अगर कोई clients हो जिनका designation managing director, joint MD या फिर वो authorized signatories हैं, उनको आप ये explain कर देना कि उनकी legal liability क्या है. Directors, managers, secretaries और कोई भी बच रहा है SMS फार्मास्यूटिकल में, बट इसके अंदर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्लियर कर दिया दैट दे विल बी एडमिटेडली इन चार्ज ऑफ द कंपनी एंड दे कैन बी डायरेक्टली इंप्यूटेड टू सेक्शन 141 बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ द ऑफिस एज दे होल्ड as MD or joint MD, these persons are in charge and responsible for the conduct of business of the company. Therefore, they get covered under section 144. So far as signatory of a check, which is, अब ये signatory की बात कर रहा है. So far as signatory of a check which is dishonored is concerned, he is clearly responsible for the incriminating act and will be covered under section 141 clause 2. So, I hope अब आपको बहुत crystal clear हो गया, company prosecute हो सकती है या नहीं, company prosecute हो सकती है. Company में कौन prosecute हो सकता है? By the virtue of designation, director, manager, secretary, नहीं, आप एक vanilla procedure नहीं है, you have to, a magistrate has to apply his judicious mind before issuing process and has to see that who is the person in charge, who is directly responsible for the transaction, for the bouncing of check, that he has to see. And one more thing, Supreme Court cleared that the authorized signatory, managing director and joint MD, they can be directly imputed to the criminal liability under 141. So, agar aapko kabhi aisa lage, aapko 138 ka case file karna hai and you don't know ki kisko aapne company ke andar party banana hai, to aap company ko party banaiye aur MD aur joint MD ya jo authorized signatory hai usko aap bana sakte hain. They will come under section 141. This will make your case strong. Aapki complaint ki uske basis pe मजिस्ट्रेट इसके अंदर समनिंग कर सकते हैं. अगर नहीं करते, यू कैन टेक दिस केस एसएमएस फार्मास्यूटिकल केस. ये बिल्कुल क्रिस्टल क्लियर इन्होंने इसको कर दिया. अब इन दोनों केसेस के अंदर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कॉन्सेप्ट दिया ऑल्टर ईगो का. नाउ ऑल्टर ईगो का कॉन्सेप्ट बहुत आगे तक ट्रेवल हुआ, एज रिसेंट एज सुनील भारती मित्तल वर्सेज सीबीआई, विच विल डिस्कस, विच इज द बेसिस ऑफ द लिटिगेशन नाउ. आई विल डिस्कस दिस जजमेंट इन डिटेल. So what does concept of alter ego says? Alter ego says the person or a group of persons that guide the business of the company would be imputed to the corporation. इसको please आप बहुत अच्छे से समझे, क्योंकि सुनील भारती मित्तल में बहुत fine analysis किया है Supreme Court ने alter ego का, that when there are person or a group of persons, they can be imputed to the body corporation. It cannot be other way around, that when there is a company, then some person can be imputed to the criminal liability. It is the person or a group of persons that guide the business of the company. Company apne aap business ko guide nahi karti, apne actions ko guide nahi karti. Some group of persons guide the business and the directions of the company. This is the concept of alter ego. Now I'm coming to the very, so we have covered 30 minutes. I'll discuss for another 20 minutes. Last 10 minutes, I'll take questions. Now, coming to the very important, very significant judgment, a recent judgment, Sunil Bharti Mittal versus CBI, very famously known as 2G Spectrum case. I'll take you through this judgment. Please read it after the session is over. So, what happened in 2G Spectrum case? Supreme Court ordered an investigation by Central Bureau of Investigation to conduct an inquiry after registering an FIR against certain persons and certain body corporates, certain companies, to see whether there was any scam which happened in the 2G spectrum or not. So, on the directions of the Honorable Supreme Court, a case was registered, and under the FIR, five persons I am saying because it includes companies also and individual also, five persons were included. Mr. Shyamal Ghosh, he was the then telecom secretary. Then I think there was the director general, Mr. Verma was there, and three companies, the Sunil Bharti Mittal's Airtel, Bharti Telecom, Hutchinson, and one more company was there. I'll tell you the name. Yeah, Sterling. So Sterling, Hutchinson, and Bharti Airtel, and Mr. Shyamal Ghosh and Mr. Verma was made an accused in the FIR. All right. So now this case will begin, that when the CBI conducted its investigation, They charge sheeted four persons in their charge sheet. Yes, Chirag. Chirag, I'll take all the questions at the end. Yes, company is treated as a person, correct. So the four persons were Mr. Shamal Ghosh, the then telecom secretary, and three companies. They were made an accused as per the charge sheet of the CBI. Now, how this dispute arise and how it reached to the Supreme Court? Because of the orders of the then CBI court of Judge O.P. Saini in Delhi, wherein he also summoned, along with these four persons, he also summoned the promoters, the directors of these three companies, Mr. Sunil Bharti Mittal, Mr. Asim Ghosh, and Mr. Ravi Ruya. And what when the charge sheet was filed, what the judge observed in its order? The judge said that the matter was taken up by special judge on such and such date and the charge sheet has been filed, apart from these four persons who are included in the charge sheet. Now the judge in its order says that at the same time, the learned special judge also found that Mr. Sunil Bharti Mittal, the CMD of Bharti Cellular Limited, Mr. Ashim Ghosh of Hutchinson, and Ravi Rui of Sterling, these persons prima facie could be treated as controlling the affairs in the respective companies and represent the directing mind and will of the company. So the impugned order also summoned these three persons, apart from what CBI said that they were not in the accused list of CBI. So obviously these three persons were aggrieved and they reached up to the Supreme Court against the summoning order of the special judge CBI. So after that, what basically happened? Now you must have understood the basic problem ki char logo ko CBI kehti hai ki ye accused hai, company teen jiske andar hai. बट स्पेशल जज सीबीआई ये कहता है कि ये जो तीन कंपनी है इनको तो प्रोसिक्यूट करो और साथ में जो इनके प्रमोटर डायरेक्टर्स हैं दे आर इक्वली लायबल बिकॉज उसके ऑर्डर में ये कहता है कि दे आर द डायरेक्टिंग माइंड एंड विल ऑफ द कंपनी. कंपनी को आप कैसे किसको भेजोगे आप इंप्रिजनमेंट में? देयर हैज टू बी समवन. सो फॉर दिस ही समन्ड द थ्री पर्सन्स, मिस्टर सुनील भारती मित्तल, रवि रुइया एंड असीम घोष. सो then it reached at the doors of the Supreme Court and they were represented by none other than the most respected stalwarts of legal fraternity, Mr. Harish Salve and Fali S. Nariman sir, and they argued. So first of all, their contention was that CBI did not include them as the accused and they were not implicated in the charge sheet, but the learned judge summoned them. So as per the provisions of CRPC, a judge always have a power at the time of taking cognizance of the charge sheet that they can summon any other person who is not part of the charge sheet after applying the judicious mind. So what were the main contentions? So the first contention of Mr. Salve when he began his argument was that the general principle is that the acts of individual who is in control of the affairs of the company and is the directing mind are attributed to the company. In as much as whenever such a person who is controlling the affairs of the company is made an accused on application of principle of alter ego. So I told you before that what alter ego is, the company can be implicated as accused person. That is okay. So now the main contention is that it is on the well recognized principle that the company, it is a well recognized principle that the company does not act on its own but through its directors, officers, and when such directors, officers act on behalf of the company is also held liable for those act on the application of principal agent formula. He submitted that it has never been a case where for the act of the company an individual is made accused. अब आप समझ रहे हैं alter ego को सालवे साहब ने बहुत फाइनली डिस्कस किया कि इट इज नेवर द केस दैट ऑन द एक्शंस ऑफ द कंपनी या इंडिविजुअल इज इंप्यूटेड. ऑल्टर ईगो क्या कहता है? ऑन द एक्शन ऑफ पर्संस एंड ग्रुप ऑफ पर्संस द कंपनी इज इंप्यूटेड. सो इट टेक्स अ वेरी फाइन लीगल माइंड टू फाइंड दिस लैकुना. नाउ आई विल टेल यू हाउ दे यू नो वर्कड ऑन दिस. He submitted that it has never been a case where for the act of the company an individual is made accused unless there is a categorical provision in the statute making such a person vicarious liable. वो स्टैट्यूट के अंदर अभी तक प्रोविजन नहीं है. देन दे लेड डाउन ऑल द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एसएमएस फार्मास्यूटिकल केस जो हम लोगों ने देखे एंड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट जजमेंट. अगेन यू शुड राइट डाउन दिस जजमेंट, इट विल बी वेरी यूजफुल. अनीता हाडा वर्सेस गॉडफादर ट्रेवल एंड टूर्स प्राइवेट लिमिटेड, इट इज ऑफ 2012. सो व्हाट डज अनीता हाडा केस सेज, व्हिच मिस्टर साल्वे ऑल्सो यूज्ड इन हिज arguments apart from SMS pharmaceutical case, that the company can have criminal liability and further if a group of persons that guide the business of the companies have the criminal intent, that would be imputed to the body corporate. In this background, section 141 act of NI act has to be understood. The said provision clearly stipulates that when a person which is a company commits an offense, then certain categories of person in charge as well as the company would be deemed to be liable for the offences under 138. Thus, the statutory intendment is absolutely plain. As is perceptible, the provision makes the functionary and the companies to be liable, and that is by deeming fiction. A deeming fiction has its own signification. So, ye us cheez ke andar, again they reiterated that a company is basically guided by a person or a group of persons, but it cannot be a reverse case. That on the act of company, a certain individual cannot be prosecuted. On the act of persons, a company can be prosecuted. So I hope you have got my point. This is very important and bahut thin point, aisa point hai ki jo generally एक लॉयर की निगाह से अगर देखें तो बहुत सिंपल एक पेडागोजी लगती है, बट इट कैन नॉट बी रिवर्स. अ ग्रुप ऑफ पर्सन कैन गाइड द कंपनी, बट अ कंपनी कैन नॉट गाइड अ पर्सन. दे आर दे मेड देयर केस, दे आर कंटेंडिंग दैट मे बी सम प्रॉब्लम हैपेंड विद द कंपनी, बट इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट ऑन द एक्शन ऑफ अ कंपनी यू विल प्रोसिक्यूट दीज थ्री पर्सन. सो दिस इज हाउ इट वेंट ऑन. So ultimately on these submissions, they got a relief from Supreme Court, and Supreme Court, I think it's the last 38 para wherein Supreme Court defined this, that how a legal imputation has to be taken care of. So I'll discuss. Yeah. So it is in para 38. Also in this case there was one thing that they also contended, that the impugned order says that they were the directing minds and they were the directing will of the company, but the order never talks about what action did they perform when if the offense is imputed to them, that on their particular actions this offense was committed. It never talked about that. So para 35 it says, the legal please hear this very attentively, the legal proposition that is laid down in the aforesaid judgment is that if the person or group of persons who control the affairs of the company commit an offense with a criminal intent, their criminality can be imputed to the company as well as their alter ego of the company. यहाँ पे सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने पहले ये डिफाइन कर दिया alter ego क्या है, कि when a person or a group of person can be their actions can be imputed to the body corporation, to the company. Now they says that in the present case, however, this principle is applied exactly in a reverse scenario. This is what I was trying to explain. कि कंपनी के एक्शंस इंडिविजुअल्स को इंप्यूट नहीं कर सकते, इंडिविजुअल के एक्शंस ग्रुप ऑफ persons के एक्शंस को कंपनी की तरफ इंप्यूट कर सकते हैं. Here company is the accused person and learned special judge, special magistrate has observed in its impugned order that since the appellant represent the directing mind and will of the company, their state of mind is the state of mind of the company, and therefore on this premise acts of companies is attributed and imputed to the appellants. Now, Supreme Court clearly says it is difficult to accept it as the correct principle of law. As demonstrated herein after, this proposition would run contrary to the principle of vicarious liability, detailing the circumstances under which a direction of company can be held liable. So, Supreme Court ने उन तीनों की जो summoning थी उसको खत्म कर दिया. On the principle, I hope you have understood that the alter ego principle was reversely applied. An individual cannot be imputed on the action of a company, whereas a individual or a group of individual can guide a company and that can be imputed to the company or a body corporation. So Supreme Court said that order is liable to be set aside if no reason is given, while coming to the conclusion that prima facie case against the accused, though the order need not contain detailed reasons. So I told you that the learned just CBI did not give a detailed reason that how these three persons, what were their actions, how they, what decisions they made, which led to the scam of 2G spectrum case. So that was not a detailed order, although Supreme Court says that the order need not to be detailed reasons, but there is no specific reason given while coming to the conclusion that a prima facie case exists against these three persons. A fortiori, the order would be bad in law if the reason given turns out to be ex facie incorrect. तो तीन जजमेंट हमने डिस्कस की है. दीज आर द वेरी बेसिस ऑफ ऑल द क्रिमिनल लायबिलिटी. इट विल कवर योर क्लाइंट इन ऑल द पर्टिकुलर सिनेरियोज वेयर इन यू विल सी दैट if whether the company can be imputed, whether who has to be imputed on the basis of specific action, and whether if the person is imputed to the legal liability, then how he can be saved, which is what is described in Sunil Bharti Mittal versus CBI. Now, very importantly, I'll describe 5 minutes of Companies Act also. So, in Companies Act 447, section 447 defines the offense and the punishment as well. I would like to talk about, you can write down this section which I'll be talking, section 212 of Companies Act, section 212, jiske andar aap generally agar aap koi Companies Act mein deal kar rahe hain, you will be seeing that SFIO, Serious Fraud Investigation Office, is investigating under this provision, and the very important point under this is that bail in Companies Act in 212 is very difficult because it has embargo of other draconian sections like PMLA, like NDPS, like MACOCA. So this has been, I don't know why and how it has been included by the legislation, and the draconian twin conditions are that at the time of bail, the judge has to be satisfied that the person is not guilty of the offense, and once if he is set free on the bail, he will not commit the same offense again. So this is, I think this is a totally unconstitutional, this is violation of Article 21, because at the time of bail you are deciding the guilt of the person. How can, which judge under this law of the land will come to the conclusion that at the time of bail he will be satisfied that the person is not guilty of the offense? This condition was there in PMLA as well. Thankfully, it reached to the doors of Supreme Court. Justice, Honorable Justice Rohinton Nariman, applied his judicious mind and in a very landmark judgment has given this verdict that it is absolutely unconstitutional. Legislation ऐसे नहीं कर सकता कि किसी को अरेस्ट करके वो ये ट्विन कंडीशन इम्पोज कर दे कि बेल के टाइम पे कोर्ट ये सेटिस्फाई होगी कि वो फिर से ऐसा ऑफेंस नहीं करेगा और वो इस ऑफेंस के लिए गिल्टी भी नहीं है. दिस इज एब्सोल्यूट वायोलेशन ऑफ आर्टिकल 21. आई थिंक सिद्धार्थ लूथरा सर हैज ऑल्सो गॉन टू द एपेक्स कोर्ट फॉर स्ट्रकिंग डाउन ऑफ दिस कंडीशन. But I can tell you in PMLA sections, this has been, in PMLA Act, this has already been struck down by Supreme Court, because at the stage of bail, one cannot decide the guilt of an accused. At the stage of bail, Supreme Court is very clear that only certain things has to be taken care of, which is that a person will not tamper witnesses, he will not flee from the country, and investigation is completed, and all other factors which you all must be knowing, you all are advocates. So that is the case. So now we have discussed more or less all the judgments. On the vicarious liability part, I will also quote some of the other sections in other acts where a vicarious liability can be there. So you can advise your clients on, say, Section 278B of Income Tax Act. There the liability arises. Then I think in PMLA, in NI Act, we have already read about Section 141. In Prevention of Corruption Act, there is Section 10, which talks about the liability. In PMLA, then there is Section 17. So these all are the important cases, and this is all about the criminal liability. One specific question I generally it comes that can a shareholder director or can a chartered accountant or a consultant or an advisor be criminally liable for the act of the company? Because there are certain cases in which now lot of startups are coming in India, and investors, when they invest money, they appoint their nominee directors who are only concerned that the interest of the investor is taken care of and the money is not diverted or siphoned off in personal accounts. So they cannot be imputed to the regular day-to-day affairs of the company. So the answer is that the person who is whole soul in charge of the company, or the director who is responsible for the acts of the company, or the managing director, joint MD, or the authorized signatory, these persons can be imputed to the criminal liability, but not everyone else. A perfect example is that in government organizations, in government companies like a bank, the central government appoints their IAS officers as directors. तो अगर स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया का कोई चेक बाउंस होगा कि क्या आप एक उस आईएएस ऑफिसर को समनिंग करा सकते हैं कोर्ट से? नो. सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने इस चीज को बहुत क्लियर कर दिया है दैट अ पर्सन हु इज इन चार्ज ऑफ द कंपनी विल हैव टू बी इंप्यूटेड, नोबडी एल्स कैन. और एसएमएस फार्मास्यूटिकल में हमने पढ़ी लिया है दैट डेजिग्नेशन डज नॉट मैटर. तो अगर आप डायरेक्टर भी बन रहे हैं तो इट डज नॉट मैटर दैट आपको हर ऑफेंस के लिए आपको क्रिमिनली इंप्यूट किया जाएगा. सो दीज आर द बेसिक थिंग्स. इट्स अ लॉन्ग टॉपिक ऑल्सो. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द की मैनेजरियल पर्सनल्स. डेजिग्नेशन डज नॉट मैटर अ मच अनलेस एंड अंटिल देर आर थ्री डेजिग्नेशंस: मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर, जॉइंट एमडी एंड द ऑथराइज सिग्नेटरी. दीज पीपल हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल एंड दे शुड बी प्रिपेयर्ड दैट इफ एनी 138 लिटिगेशन कम्स इन दैट दे कैन बी समन्ड. 138 की समनिंग का मैंने आपको बता दिया है दैट दे विल हैव टू अ मजिस्ट्रेट हैज टू अप्लाई जुडिशियस माइंड एंड सेक्शन 203 कैन बी यूज्ड. सीआरपीसी पावर्स अंडर सेक्शन 203 सीआरपीसी कैन बी यूज्ड बाय देम इफ दे फील दैट द कंप्लेंट डज नॉट हैव एनी इंक्रिमिनेटिंग मटीरियल ऑन रिकॉर्ड विच शोज द इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द पर्सन हु इज बिन एक्यूज, एंड दे कैन डिसमिस द कंप्लेंट देयर ओनली एंड नो समनिंग टेक्स प्लेस. So these all are the things. We are left with last 7-8 minutes. Now I can take questions on this topic. I think Chirag had some question. So Chirag, I've told you that company is treated as a person. Standard Chartered Bank judgment मैंने आपको बताया है 2005 का. Sir, if a check is bounced, that why are both parties bound to pay for it? Why not the person who haven't managed money in a bank? I think this question is not clear. So if a check is bounced, then a person who is liable to pay, the person who has signed, and if it is the case of the company, then the in charge of the affairs of the company who is directly liable for that transaction will have to pay. Will have to face the prosecution. Sir, but the cases related to the company are to be argued in NCLT and then further NCLAT for further relief if someone want. See, NCLT and NCLAT courts are guided by the Companies Act. Here, Chirag, we are talking about the criminal liability, which are guided by the criminal courts of this country. So 138 is by the Special Criminal Court, which is the Negotiable Instruments Court, and the other are the normal magisterial or the sessions court, which deals with the offenses. So a company or an individual or director or other person are only basically related with their trial takes place in the general courts only, not NCLT and NCLAT. NCLAT and NCLT deals with the company law matters. Sir, is a company secretary liable along with joint director and other? See, I told you, Chirag, as per the SMS pharmaceutical case, there is nothing in the designation. If a company secretary is in charge of issuing checks or in charge of carrying out that particular transaction, or if the company secretary has signed on the check, then only they can be liable. But it is not necessary that company secretary can be imputed to the offense every time that there is a prosecution against a company. So vicarious liability does not mean that you are a company secretary and you can be directly imputed. The magistrate will certainly apply the judicious mind before issuing the summoning and issuing the process. So strict and vicarious liability, we have ascertained 138 and 141. Then position of independent directors, CA and auditors, I have already told that please don't be fearful of advising companies in the capacity of chartered accountants and as advisors or consultants, because there is no direct imputation unless and until you have signed the check or you are directly responsible for that particular transaction, and there is absolutely no fearful thing. Thank you, Shirak. Nothing to fear that if you are associated with the company, a legal a criminal liability can be arised. So Pranjal has a question, sir, since the company can be prosecuted and the person who has actual criminal intention will be prosecuted, or the principle of alter ego be applied? So Chirag, see, alter ego concept is very well cleared by Supreme Court in CBI in Sunil Bharti Mittal case. Main aapko layman mein bata language mein bata deta hu ki alter ego ka concept kya hai. कि एक पर्सन के एक्शन या एक ग्रुप ऑफ पर्सन के एक्शन जो कंपनी में काम करते हैं या कंपनी में किसी कैपेसिटी में, दे कैन गाइड द कंपनी टू एक्ट इन अ सर्टेन वे, बट कंपनी का कोई एक्शन किसी स्पेसिफिक एम्प्लॉय की तरफ इंप्यूट नहीं किया जा सकता. सो अगर किसी ने कोई क्रिमिनल इंटेंट के साथ कोई एक्ट कंपनी से कराया है, देन कंपनी कैन बी प्रोसिक्यूटेड एज अलोंग विद दैट पर्सन. बट अगर कंपनी में किसी कंपनी ने कोई क्रिमिनल एक्ट किया है, देन इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी कि रिवर्स अप्लाई हो और सब लोगों के ऊपर ये चीज अप्लाई हो जाए, राइट? सो दिव्या आस्क्ड, सर, इफ डायरेक्टर फंक्शन इज ऑफ नॉन एग्जीक्यूटिव नेचर, कैन बी लायबल फॉर ऑफेंस अंडर सेक्शन 138 इफ ही वुड हैव बर्डन ऑफ प्रूफ ऑफ नॉट बीइंग इन्वॉल्वड एट द टाइम ऑफ ऑफेंसेस. एब्सोल्युटली, इट्स अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन दिव्या. Non-executive capacity in a company doesn't really, give you a criminal liability. SMS Pharmaceutical, Anita Hada case, both makes it clear. And द पर्सन इन चार्ज विल बी क्रिमिनली लायबल और द मैनेजिंग डायरेक्टर और जॉइंट एमडी और ऑथराइज सिग्नेटरी एंड इन केस somehow if a summon is received by a non-executive person then he will have a remedy to go to the higher court maybe session or high court and there they can prove their bona fide because the law says on the contrary if they prove that they were not involved and under revision they can get that summoning cancelled because dekhiye 138 mein ek legal lacuna to hai ki jo court summon kar rahi hai wo court के पास मौका ही नहीं है उस एक्यूज को सुनने का बिफोर समनिंग हिम. सो आई एम वेरी होपफुल एंड श्योर कि अभी हाईकोर्ट में रेफरेंस पेंडिंग है, इसके अंदर चेंज आएगा जरूर. बिकॉज अगर आप किसी को समन कर रहे हैं, यू शुड गिव एम्पल अपॉर्चुनिटी टू दैट पर्सन टू हियर एंड हियर हिज वर्जन एंड हिज स्टोरी दैट हाउ ही इज नॉट पर्टिकुलर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर ट्रांजेक्शन. So last 1 minute. So if anyone else has any question. All right. So it's been a wonderful session. Thank you everyone who all joined. And my email ID is somsom_prateek PRATEEK @yahoo.com. In case you will have questions, I will be very happy to help you out and let's be in touch and thank you so much. Priya, there, should I end the video?